I'm just walking with my wolf. Poison, poison, poison. Such a good game mechanic. See, I don't mind the curse and all of that, and that's basically the same thing as poison. It's just less intrusive and, for lack of a better word, well, I won't say it, but I think you can probably imagine the word I was about to say. But the other ones feel like there's something you can do about them, or you can try to avoid them. Poison just feels like, oh, I'm poisoned now. That sucks. There's that annoying prick. Those souls. Let's see if I can get out without getting hit once. As soon as I get hit once, I'm going to get stunlocked. And that's a lot of skeletons. I kind of... Oh, hello. Got lost, did you? That's it. I want to drag the skeletons away from that big guy. And then run to the big guy. Pick him off. That'll do. Then I want to try to get past the skeletons without getting screwed over. Because that's not a good place to fight them. And then I can see whether they respawn or not. Nice, jumping attack. Take your potion. Skeletons are like, daylight, back off, back away. Almost cursed. Oh, look how close to being cursed I am there. I get the feeling I really don't want to be cursed. It's the sort of thing that maybe you need to use an item to get rid of. It won't fade away. Oh. That second attack I did didn't seem to hit him. Well, the good news is none of them have seemed to respawn. So, I'll go and double check. Hello. I curse you, Kirsty. Yeah, these skeletons aren't respawning, so that's cool. So cursing, according to Thomas, lowers your health by 10%, basically. The same as dying once. So, yeah, it's pretty annoying, at the very least, because my health is already 50%, and pretty much will always be 50%. Because I just don't see how I'm not going to die in this game. Two pathways. Don't tase me, bro. This kills my OCD. Give me those linear paths. Feels like I'm going back to myself. Am I going back on myself? I actually think I am. Yes, I am. Oh well, at least I have some sense of direction then, because I could recognise that I was going back to where I'd already been. Feels like an illusionary wall. They always say that though. Illusion ahead. Look. I don't see it though. So. Could either go down there or go up here. Still a new pathway. suspicious. Yes. Very suspicious. Fell for that one. I kind of want to come across a bonfire soon because I've run out of Estus flasks. This is going to get worse before it gets better. That probably joins up with the previous path. So that's an illusion, maybe. Invaded! Merciless row. Oh, that's the NPC. Why would I want to be up here then? This doesn't seem to do anything. I'm not blind, am I? I don't see anything, I can't interact with it. And I'm getting hit by this prick. I kind of want to kill these quickly because I have been invaded. Some sort of key, so that's going to be useful. Now this is the lower path, so it's all meeting up now. Sussing out the area. Quite a lot of damage. Cool. Go for blows! Don't kill me! No! I knew it was going to do that. They always do that, don't they? Just one more attack. That's a long way to run back now. That is a long way to run back.
Yeah. Oh boy. Well, I just lost shitloads of souls there. Kinda depressed after that now. Cause it's fair enough if I die. But when I die and the guy has like one health and I basically just wanted to do one more attack and I just couldn't quite manage it with the stamina I had left, it's so depressing because it's like, well, there's not really anything more I could have done. And I'm now screwed. And all of that hard work is for nothing now because all of those mobs have respawned, so what are you going to do? Okay, rolling to the right doesn't work. That's a nice spin. There's no counter in that one, that's for sure. So basically, this dude is an AoE dude. You stay away from him, because he just AoEs the shit out of you. I've kinda had enough now. I'm not annoyed with that, because, like I say, that's all that hard work gone for nothing. I think from now on, I think any time I can spend even one lot of souls, I'm gonna do it. I'm just gonna teleport back to base and just do it. Because I can't be dealing with losing 6,000 souls or something like that. It's probably nothing in the long run compared to monsters I get later on. And I know that's just the case, but it's painful. Especially when you've worked so hard for it and you've killed basically about 40 mobs to get there in Dark Souls 2, which aren't exactly necessarily easy mobs. One more attack. Good luck. Done ganking me yet? Get out. That's cheeky. Where the hell did you come from? I guess I just got a few souls for killing that invader, but I didn't get much else. Pretty sure there should be a bonfire coming up soon. And I got a key earlier, so maybe I can open up a door that's about to come up. Another two pumps. That looks like it leads to a boss. I was almost expecting something really stupid to happen, where you just get knocked over by the bomb or waterfall. I don't think I trust going through there yet, in case it takes me to a boss. I need to explore a little bit more. See, I'm dead again. There's my undead friend over there. I try hard. Oh, sneaky bugger. That'll learn you. That was close. I just got the jump off there. A split second later and I was screwed. I feel like I've been here before. Am I going around in circles again? Kind of. This is the other end. I just got myself a flame butterfly. What did you just get? Okay, that guy doesn't seem to mind getting stabbed. Really risky there. So, we're going to open up this zone. Or is this a new area? Shouldn't be. No, it isn't. The skeletons have just respawned. That's all. But it's not new. So that means I can now take that shortcut next time, if I want to. And this is a dead end. So I basically have to go through the mist. Watch that guy fail. That is fun. I mean, the game is genius for putting in things like essentially other players doing things like the bloodstains and such. You can see where they've fallen and messed up. Normally the ones where they fall off the cliff and stuff like that are the best ones. We just got picked off. Okay. Oh, it's a bloody boss, isn't it? That seems to follow me. Oh, is he going to respawn? I hope not. Skeletons are spawning in their place. A lot of skeletons. I want to get to him, but I can't quite. There's a lot of skeletons in the way. A lot. No more healing though. Oh, those attacks missed. I could not afford for that. They needed to hit. Do not go and miss on me. Jeez, that was rough. Oh, those dodges! He dodged that well, didn't he? Jesus. Come on. There we go, he's down. Have I just got to take down skeletons or am I done? God, I still got to have to kill the skeletons. I don't want to take any damage. This is where... Shite. I don't know how I can possibly maneuver through my inventory. Oh, there's what? There's these now? Oh man, I think I'm dead. It's a bit much, isn't it? Come on. Oh dear. That's overkill, that is. Okay. Here we go again. This is where it's going back to its soul, Dark Souls roots, where you've got like a 5-minute run back, which is not cool. Never is. That was lucky. almost didn't let me roll by him. Oh, wrong way. Souls. Kind of hard to not take damage from these skeletons because they don't really care. When they get attacked, they don't really stumble. Might need to two-hand it. Wow. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna go back to base. It's doable, but it's not really realistic with just three Estus flasks. Almost need to use a human effigy or something, I don't know. Black firebomb would be good in a situation like that. Probably need a bigger sword or something like that as well. When you got giant, well, masses of skeletons like that, some big ass two-hand sword or something would do the trick nicely. Yeah, I could do that. I could try that co-op thing anyway, because like you mentioned it, it's something I've got to do. Just to practice it, really, just to understand it. That guy's always a bit funny. You roll by him, but you don't really roll past him. He just doesn't move for you. He's a bit of a dick like that. Where's my souls? Where's my souls? The pursuer is an easy boss. Sure is. Especially if you get the cat ring. Then it makes it too easy. Right, Majuli.
Bearer of the seek the lest this land.
Wanna give me something at least? Fatality. Done. I like that I'm slowly starting to understand the game more and recognise the areas, like being able to just, you know, go from zone to zone and understand it a little bit better, know where I'm heading to as well. Makes it a lot more enjoyable. I've always thought that Dark Souls is, this type of game is actually a game that you'd enjoy more the second time through. Because once you know what you're doing, it's more enjoyable just to try to work out, or just to see how well you can do it. Whereas the first time it's just like smashing your face against a brick wall. You are going to die, and it's going to be painful. And I get that. But it's not really fun, no matter what way you look at it. Yeah, that's a little stab there. Not much, though. Shall I try and do a jumping attack on this guy? Okay, that didn't do anything. So basically drop a sign here or something, because this is where the thingy-majig would be. Last time I got summoned really quickly. Cancel summon sign. Cancel. Or okay. It's a little confusing, but yeah, you have to assume that cancel means no. Okay, well, whilst we're waiting to get summoned, I'll have a little look at my inventory or something, because I'm hoping it will happen soon. Banish phantoms. Few the names of the glorious champions. Do I get to sort of judge people again? Look at the score on that guy. How the hell... all these other people are like, you know, close. These are normal scores. Does this just mean that this person's cheating? When someone's got like 8 times, you know, the amount that the next person has. Is he cheating or something? I can't see what his gear is. Unless you can recognise what his gear is. Blue Sentinels, that's where I belong to. He's got 838. Yeah, he's cheating, look at that. Or he's just been playing non-stop and has leveled up. He's got 99 in all of those stats and 838 in intelligence, I guess. Whereas the next person also has 99 and 838. So that's the max, is it, or something? Even so, how the hell is his score so high? Cool. It's not very easy to... I can't look at Silvio for some reason. He's banned. So that's the maximum amount of stats you can have, and I'm being summoned now. How many goes does this guy want? I did this fight on 50% health and no armor, baby. And this guy's using 2 people. This is a good fight to gank with. Oh, wow. Almost. Nice try there. I can't actually use, what's it called? My healing potion. What the hell? That's a weird delay. I'm gonna die. I'm scared of him doing a slashing attack. Whoa, there you go. That easy, huh? I got a lot of souls there, didn't I? Quite a lot. That looked like I got about 4,000 or something, because I think I had 2,000. And I've got a smooth and silky stone. Hmm. Well, that seems kind of a productive way to make souls, doesn't it? That only took about a minute, I guess. Maybe 2 minutes. And I got 4,000 souls for it. Early on in the game, that's kind of powerful. It wasn't particularly difficult. Mostly because he had two other guys. Well, there was three of us in total. Can I stack the cat rings? If I have two of them, does that mean I take even less damage from falling? I can get four rings. I could get four of them. I wonder if anyone's going to use that summon sign again. Or whether it has like a timer before it can be used again. It makes you think, huh? Invade the world of the guilty. That has to be used in a certain area, I think. I'm not sure where though. These Dragon Rider souls, Soul of the Pursuer. Normally, they're used to upgrade weapons in a specific way, so I'm not going to use those. Light Torch autonomously. Just kind of waiting to get summoned again, but I don't know if that's going to happen. Look at that sea. Is that pre-rendered? It's pretty good. There's another giant. Have I got to wake them up or something? My summon sign was still on the floor. I don't know whether I've got to redo it or not. Maybe you need to redo it. I should be able to get two more upgrades now. How you doing?
Bearer of the list.
Do we have to do this speech every time? Every frickin' time. Yay! Two upgrades. Check that out. Seventy-six. Still need some work. What I kinda needed is I need to buy some items to help me on that boss fight. Like maybe a bit more health or something.
bearer of the... Seek so, seek the king. That is the only way. Lest this...
I have a smooth and silky stone, so I want to know what I'm going to get for it. I'm going to get some amazing stuff. I figured I'd try my luck again on the illusionary walls. Now that I've just made everyone go cross-eyed. And... that also reminds me, ages ago there was this guy.
See that statue? Hey.
Can you not go back to the starting zone? Feels like... how else did I get there? Because the starting zone had that big monster as well, if I recall, and I never killed that. I don't know whether I can get back there. It doesn't look like I can. This looks like a one-way road. Oh, how do I get back? Maybe I can't. Anyone know? Okay, that's one way to do it. I should go back and see how the old ladies are doing. See if they got anything new to say to me. What's up?
Still do you?
Do I want to start all that? Reallocate points. How many times can I reallocate points? Out of curiosity.
No, of course not. Now go along then.
Just curious. If it's a one-off thing, but if you can do it like as many times as you like, I'd probably reallocate and get rid of some of my strength and dexterity. Because that only requires 11 strength. Don't really need that much. I'm going to try it. Oh, she doesn't want to say anything to me now.
Still, do you wish?
Soul Fessel? I don't have one. So you need a soul vessel to do it.
What's needed? Well, go along.
So it's doable, but
no,
you need a particular item to do it. And that item is probably quite rare. There's that guy.
Yes, you! Give us Seeky!
That guy. I never actually went this way. Now, I'm gonna do this thing that I saw in this video. And I don't know what it does, because the guy didn't tell me. Basically didn't want to give up any spoilers, and I think I'm dead now. I actually did press the button. Yeah, I'm dead. Oh, maybe not. I'm left with one health. I got to that. I pressed the button to do it, but I don't know whether it's I was hoping to get some invulnerability frames, but okay. I'll guide them a little bit further away from it and then go to it, in case there's like a 3-second timer before I'm invulnerable. But yeah, I saw the video and I was like, oh yeah, you can get in the coffin. And something happens, but he didn't say what happens, he didn't want to spoil it. I can't invade because I haven't got cracked eye. Or you should get those more often, really. Here we go. Get in there. That's what should have happened the first time. The nature of your being has changed. So, I don't know what it's done. They are big guys. Oh, that guy respawned. Bit heavy taking on two of them. I even took damage for doing that. It's a bit of a shame, because I thought that was pretty classy. Luckily, I didn't die there. I don't know if this is the way you're supposed to kill them. At least with two of them at the same time. They're not quite doing what I want them to do now, but yeah, running and jumping at them. That's ridiculous. That is ridiculous. I fucking get killed by him sort of sitting down on me, even though he doesn't sit down on me straight away. That's kind of stupid, but okay. Shouldn't really be dying to that. Huh, that's a nice miss. And that's a terrible miss. Say goodbye to your health. These aren't that hard, you just need to not get shit on, basically. It's up to them whether you get shit on or not. It's not really up to you. I guess you can't do that. So don't jump on them, just run off to take less damage that way. Notice how my health is higher for some reason. I don't remember using a human effigy. Wow! Now that was unrealistic. That was very, very unrealistic. That is one agile ogre. Holy shit, how the hell he did that, I do not know. Doing the utmost impossible. These guys are annoying now. Oops. Oh no, you don't. This guy's gonna get me. I have to run back this way. He would get me if I went up those ramps.
chance. No, I'm not even going to risk that. So close to getting one of them down. Don't! Fuck that. Bastards. Okay. I didn't get anything for them. Maybe it was another one. Oh, all of that. All of that hard work. I know one of them drops a ring. That's pretty good for this character. But it's not those. It is another. That's where I came from. Oh man. Where's the other one then? Well, at least I did the coffin thing. So this is the entrance to Majuli. Well, how do I get to that beach bit then with the big guy? Someone must know. It must be back that way, because it's that sort of area. Kill two of them, but it's not the right one. I've already scouted this area quite a bit before at the start of the game as well, so I'm not sure where the other bugger is hiding. How did you survive that? Yeah, this is just leading back to... Come on. No one knows? Since I'm here, it's like, I may as well, but I can always save it and then check it out on YouTube another day and come back and do it. Because it's like a beach area like this, but maybe I need to... If I run, though, am I just going to get killed by going into the water too deep? Yes. Yes, I am. Where is it, then? Where is it? No one knows. Hmm.
Looks like they don't respawn. I've already gotten this. Hello, sexy time. I suppose you don't know either how to get to that other ogre. Seems to... Unless it's in through here. Aha! No? Where's that ogre? It's not fair. Honestly, don't know how to get to him then. It must be another zone or something. Be running around here all day. This is just going to be the first entrance. I am getting nowhere. Aha! Thank you. I should guide him back to the old lady's house. See what happens. Got a lot of health. Ah, he won't go. Where you going, bro? Where you going? Come at me! See shit. There you go, little fella. Stone ring. Well, we don't need the reduced full damage for the moment. Additional reduction of enemy poise. Poise! That's good. Gold pine resin. I recognise that. I don't know why. There are no cracked orbs. Those are not cracked orbs. Maybe for another time. Or I can do one, and then I'm going to bed. What the hell did I pick up? I don't even know what I just... Oh, there we go. Dark pine resin. Or something like that. I know where this goes. Batman roll. Loves the vitality. Menu is so schizo. Come on, inventory. Work with me here. Oh, can't use it here. Why can't I use it here? I'll just go and use it in the area that I know you can use it, and I can't use the bonfire. It's kind of annoying. I actually kind of want to die here though. I can't use it in this area anymore. What have I got to do to use this cracked eye orb? Ugh, I still can't use it. The hell? Why not? Anyone know? Oh, human form, right. Oh, well that's no good. That means I've got to use an effigy. And I can't really afford to use those. Yeah, that sucks. I won't be doing that then. Drop my sign. These people always summon so many. What's this guy doing? Trolling. We get that again, do we? Time we get in there. Careful, mate. Careful. One of the guys was doing a bit more damage last time, I think. Because we can tank for him, because he doesn't want to die. It doesn't matter too much if we die. I guess if you're being kind, trying to help this guy out. Token of fidelity. Okay, so I'm human now. In all of my glorious beauty. So that's a good way to get your health back, is to help someone else. Alright, fair enough. Let's do it. Time to invade. At last, I live. He hasn't got the soldier key. Dead guy there. Maybe he has. It's all so quiet. I could be really annoying. I've got a poison throwing knife, so if I manage to get any successful throws on him, I could just poison him down. That'd be a nuisance. That reminds me of a jump I need to do. And that's also... Oh look, there he is. Does he even know I'm behind him? Oh, I don't think he saw that coming. He's taking his pots. Wow, that was well done. You actually managed to get behind me there. I don't know whether that was a fluke or not. You might have me here. Yeah, he's got me. Because I moved left, trying to dodge that, and then forgot that there was a pillar there. It's a bit cheeky though, he did heal up like twice there, if not three times. That was a little bit cheeky. He did one good thing, but otherwise he got behind me, but it felt like that was a little bit fluky. I don't feel like he did that kind of deliberately. I feel like he fluked a little bit there, and then he enjoyed taking lots of potions afterwards. It was a bit faggoty when they do that. He was waiting in the starting zone as well. That guy. It's a lot of spell casts, isn't there? Just gonna get him to use up all of his charges. Should have about 30. How have I lost health? That's weird. It does more damage than it looks like it does. Wow, these casters, man. Seems a little bullshit, doesn't it? Hold up your staff and just spam spells. I'm not even sure if blocking would do much there. Let's see if I can get at least one success. Seems like the casters know what to do though. I like how one of his abilities did damage to me, even though it didn't even touch me. Oh shit. He's got help. This is what I need to do. Screw him over. More casters. That fucking spell! It doesn't even have to hit you, and it hits you. Fuck that spell! You seeing that shit? Sure do love the fucking summons. So we got two. Well, everyone's a fucking caster by the looks of it. Boom! 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 And even when you're fucking not next to the missile. Here I am, missile. My health bar dropped. Huh? Has it got some huge AoE ability? If so, then the missile should be like wider so you can actually physically see what you've got to dodge. Rather than getting hit by something that doesn't fucking hit you. If you get what I'm saying. I think I've got one more fucking go. So let's get one more caster and be done with this. That's fucking bullshit. I so outplayed them as well. But how well can you outplay someone going all the fucking time whilst they got a summon in front of them? Proper faggotry shit. Time to start using those fucking poison knives, I think, if people are going to be such faggots about it. Hey, it's a big guy. You gonna go take a pot? What's he doing? He was like, I have to go now. My home planet needs me. Oh, what was that? Oh well, I got my token of spite. My work here is done. Finally, someone that isn't going that is lame. Okay. That's me. Ooh. Dumb. So thank you very much for watching. Thanks for coming along, and I shall see you later. Hello, welcome back to Dark Souls 2. It has been quite a while since I last played this. A number of days. Not for you, though, who is watching the video. And if you're watching the video, why? But, yes. There's a couple of things I wanted to do, because I've been looking through some Dark Souls guides and stuff like that, because I'm starting to get into the game, even when I'm not playing it. And there's one little place I want to go to, and that's... just got to remember how to get there, but there's a branch, basically. It's not this way. I'm guessing I've got to go down here to get there. But it is making me think. But I'm just going to kind of finish up with a couple of areas that I think I might have missed out on. It's a little bit of a cheat to some degree. But there we go. It's the branch. And I don't think I would have naturally come across it myself. Maybe given enough time I would have. But for example, that... is where I want to get to. I've got to work out how to do it. Oh, that'll do it. And there's some guy there. Likes to fire arrows at me, but yes, this is a little sort of, not exactly a secret area as such, but clearly an area that you can get to if you actually decide to use a bit of initiative, which I haven't done thus far. I actually need a guy to do so. And I might want to pick up a few things on my way. And otherwise, I don't think there's that much else I've missed out on, and if there is anything else, I'm just going to kind of leave it. Because, again, I'm going to get into this game quite a lot, and I suspect that I might not catch it all in the video. Oh, I just messed up there. I think that leads to more than just that. Now, I hope it does, because there's a whole area that I want to explore near where the fire critter is. I've got to work out how to get there. These guys look like they're... that looks like it leads to somewhere. So it's things like that. I thought I was going to mess that up. But look, already here's something as well. Torch. Ooh. Oops, I forgot. Tease my parry. I thought that was a parry there. I shouldn't get too obsessed with the parries though. It always gets me into a lot of trouble. Right. We don't go too far down there yet. Let's just try to suss out the areas. Okay, looks like I'm going to go down here for now. Ladder, right? Not sure how my second hit didn't get it, but we'll just put it down to magic. So we're back over here. I'm not sure if I've got anything over that side to do. So we're going to want to go here and not get arrowed in the back. The thing that annoys me a little bit in this game is I'm never quite sure whether they've dropped something, so you almost have to hang around a little bit. I want to move on straight away, but at the same time kind of need to stay fixated on him so that I know that he hasn't dropped anything. So there's a ladder going up there. I'm going to go up here first. Ah, that's it. That leads to a nice NPC guy who should help me out. Because this looks like it's kind of linear. There's not much up here, probably. Did a guard break there. See, I didn't think there'd be much up here, but just out of curiosity, just have a little look-see. I bet I've missed something as well. People are like, he went right by it. I definitely want to get back to the ladder though. Where the hell's the ladder? It's like I went up, but I don't know how to get back down. Oh, I get it. That's why I can't get back. So I will actually... That's kind of annoying. I guess that's the, revenge. That's the sacrifice you make. It's to kill that guy, you have to basically then screw yourself over a little bit and do this whole bit over again. Okay, give me a moment. That'll do, pig. That'll do. Let's go in here. Oh, that's it. Cheating again. I know the bolt is coming. Oh! Oh! Do you know what? I saw it, and then for some reason, might have been a Twitch reaction, I pressed forward. I was right on the edge. I didn't know what it was at first, and then I saw it. Saw what it was, but I pressed my finger by the time I... That's good. I didn't think there was going to be much of anything down there. And the video doesn't show you everything. It wasn't like a specific video guide either, for like, oh, here's all the cheats and stuff like that. It's just like, when I was looking up these guides and stuff, and people were just showing the areas they're running around, I was like, oh, I didn't know you could do that one, or I didn't know you could do that. Oh, I thought I wasn't going to make that. Something felt wrong there. Something feels really wrong. The fuck, I'm going to die here. I'm in a really rough spot. Something I want to use a lot Ah, oh my god! He wasn't sprinting. That's really bad. But, in my defense, he didn't sprint. And I was holding down A to sprint, and then I was... You might have heard me going like that, which is jump. I'm pretty sure I had stamina left, so I don't know why he didn't do it. But, he didn't. Either way, let's go back. I don't really care at this point now when I lose a number of souls. If I lose like 5,000 plus souls or something, I'll be a little bit annoyed, but even not that much, because I'm probably starting to get into the game where you're getting to the point where you start to accumulate like a stupid amount of souls. Actually, let's just make this a little bit cleaner. Right, this is what should have happened. But for some reason, sprint never seemed to happen. Hello, chat room. Hello. Oh, I was wondering if a boulder was going to come again there. Nope. We don't want to go that way. We want to go up. To great glory.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just daydreaming, I think. My name is Kale. I'm a traveler, like yourself. I'm navigating the continent to create a map. Why cartography, you ask? Well, that's a good question. When I first came into this forsaken land, it was... a curse?
He's forgetful.
Something about a curse. How embarrassing. I seem to have lost my focus. But I do know one thing for certain. I have always been very fond of maps. I came to this land some time ago. Drangleic, the Lost Kingdom. It sounded so romantic. Have you seen Majula? Oh, there's a rather spacious mansion there. I've made it my temporary home. Well, as something of a squatter, I'm afraid.
What is that guy doing? Shall we make it a bit more dodgy? Yeah, I don't want to kill him. I'm trying to remember what my hotkeys are. There you go. Just reached mature audience now.
Inside the mansion, I found a strange map, like none I'd ever seen. I believe that it's a map of Drenleic.
Yeah, I love maps.
Now I'm traveling the land to prove it. Yes. Yes, that's it. That's why I came to the kingdom. Wait. No. That wasn't it. Then what? I don't seem to recall.
He does go on a bit, doesn't he?
You came for that map. Wonderful. Then you are fascinated by maps, just like me.
Yeah. Love them.
Shame on you. You should have told me before.
Slipped my mind.
Here, take this. A key to the mansion.
Cheers, bro. Well, this is going
to
be useful because...
What a joy to meet a kindred spirit out here.
That leads to an Estus flask part. So more Estus flask is always a good thing.
Such a...
And again...
Oh, I would not... I can't be certain. Something about it. I'll be
I would have thought the mansion was quite linear.
And
but maybe there's...
I'll be perhaps
I don't think the mansion would have like a whole zone in itself, because you may not even come across this guy, so you're missing out on an entire zone. But then again, the game is the way it is, and it's not exactly very straightforward, or you could, as a new player, miss out a whole ton of it, because, you know, it just doesn't hold your hand. And in some ways that's a good thing, other ways that's a bad thing, and it looks like I'm kind of oh, there's the ladder. Before I say I'm screwed. Not just yet. Oh, I get to kill that guy again. Oh. Nope. I still got a fat man roll. But need to get rid of that. I like being fast. One of my favourite things in games is to be a fast character. I hate being slow, but that's kind of what I am. Oh. There's probably a couple of other bits that I've missed out, but I can't really remember them off the top of my head what I need to do, so I'm not going to worry about it, and if it happens naturally, then so be it. Now, I have choices. I can go to the Pirate Bay area, but I might save that. I might go to that, actually, but I want to kind of do the undead boss first. I've got to remember how to get there. There's also the Hades Tower of Flame that leads to a zone that I could do. Let's see if I can get to the skeleton. One thing I needed to know though is it's basically the three necromancers. Do they keep summoning skeletons like over and over and over, or do they summon a set amount so that way you actually kill the skeletons and then the big necromancers if you want to do it the safest way? I'm kind of heavy actually, my character. A lot of this is coming back to me as I'm doing it. Oh, I should have gone to Majula. Oops. I did get the key after all. I'll do that in a moment. Don't want to get surrounded. Got to keep an eye on my stamina bar as well when I'm doing all of this. Make sure that I don't exhaust it and then wonder why I can't roll. Play it cool, bro. okay. Where's the other one? I feel like I've lost one. Ah, there we go. Shame you can't get them to hit each other, like in old school games, where you could get the monsters to attack each other and then they'd actually get pissed off with each other. I like how his skull changes when he dies. Almost got a complete two for that.
Whoa! Shit! Combo breakers.
Oh well, I did really well there, and that wasn't even very hard. I just got screwed at the end there. That guy did a third attack. I didn't think he was going to do a third attack, and then that combined with the fireball in the back sealed the deal. That was a little screwed over, because I should have one-shot that. I basically had that in the bag, because there was only one guy left. But of course, I played it a little bit too risky. I wanted to lose as much health as possible before using the Estus Flask. Now I'm tilting already. Poison. Kind of just, yeah. I don't know what I'm doing. I need to refresh, reset. I should have died there. I'm kind of annoyed about that because that's what's making me screw up now. Shouldn't have died there. I deserved it, basically, which is just what's annoying me. I feel like I got screwed over in that last one. Getting a sky. He actually was running towards me before he normally does. That was kind of weird. I almost should reset, to be honest, so fuck it. I'll go do that. It's time to tilt already. one in the middle. Now on the right.
Still got help.
I'm gonna be greedy and try to get one more hit in before I take a flask. Oh, well, that'll do it, to be honest. I was rolling there, but because I got hit by the skeleton, I couldn't roll, and then I took the fireball as well. Don't let me get another hit, mate. Gone super defensive now. I could go in for the hit, but I just get the feeling that as soon as I do, I'm going to get screwed, so I'm trying to provoke as much as I can out of him. It's been very, very tricky to play with. I might end up just going for it. Trying to get him to do one thing in particular, but he wouldn't do it. Now this is the embarrassing bit. If I die to these skeletons. Oh wait, they're fucking not skeletons. Oh, that's why I got screwed over before. That's nice. That's very nice, where they both ended up there. So yeah, I rushed through the boss before and other times. And I ended up with those on top of the bosses, which you don't want. She's not particularly a difficult fan. I think I should have one-shot it before, but... yeah, it's fine. Illusionary wall. Really, though? I don't think so. That is a lot of skulls. A lot of bones. Now, I'm kind of expecting there to be a bonfire around here as well. So then I can just go back to my Julie. rest up. See, I'm decaying now. I've lost my face paint. That's other players, in case you're new to the game. I thought a boulder blocked me there. That almost looks like a boulder's blocking the way, but it's not. The textures are kind of samey in this game, but I don't mind. As long as the FPS is top-notch, that's all that matters. And I'm streaming at the moment, so this is still quite playable. If I wasn't streaming, it would be really quite good. Well, there's a new poison. There's more poison. I'm going to travel to Majuli.